Hey, y'all. I got my bathrobe on. I got a sweater on. I got my hood on. I got my hat on. I got my headphones on. I'm ready for action. Rachel's eating pumpkin bread. I don't know what she was putting in her mouth. Anyways. Welcome back for the finale episode of Little Nightmares 2. Yeah, I'm ready to be done with this scary series because it scares me. And I know I'm going to be jumping to another scary series soon, but that's okay, because what are you going to do? So, So, I guess without too much further ado, we'll just go ahead and jump on into her. This recording might be a little longer than an hour. I'm not sure exactly how much time I have left, but we're finishing it this freaking episode. Right, Rachel?
Yeah, because you already called it the finale.
Yeah, I called it the finale in an Instagram post. Now, I refuse to change my mind now. Oh boy. I love that music that's coming from the TV. I'm sad I have to go into there. Yep. Ooh. I didn't like that eyeball. TVs are like, obviously, their own little portals. Okay. So what I need to do is... And there we go. Can't fool me all the time, game, but when you do, you fool me really hard, thoroughly, for multiple frustrating minutes. Sometimes, even like a half a playthrough. Whoops. I didn't press jump, I guess. I think I just tried to use the momentum and fall off. Nope. I didn't press X the first time. Thank you. There we go. Ew, why did the level get so tippy? Huh? Why'd I get so tippy? I was gonna say, it looked like there was like a... There we go, okay. Now I understand. That was pretty goofy. Whoops, missed it again. Ooh. unladylike. He gave me... Oh. I was going to say, this is... I mean, that was like one of the little things from the first game. Little dolls that you break is a collectible. That looks like... a picture of the lady from the last game. But I don't know why that would be here. Okay. Oh, your controller is dead, huh, Rachel? Oh, okay, I see. Okay. But I need to get her lured away and get the TV back on and beat her over to it, basically.
That's what you're supposed to use for,
though. No, I couldn't carry it this far. Okay. I can't turn that TV off. Oh, okay. I understand. Oh, maybe I don't. What the fuck? What the fuck? I turned it off once, didn't I?
Yeah.
She ran after me? I'm very confused now. I don't understand what I was doing wrong. Do you see anything, Rachel? I mean, I feel like I... generally understand what to do.
It's just so weird that that TV's not working.
Right, I think is there something else I'm supposed to be doing before I do this? I need your phone. Hold on, y'all. I have to refer to a fucking guide again, because this shit is so not intuitive. Yep, it says turn on the TV outside. Turn on the TV that is outside the window and turn off the one that is in the room. Exactly what I've been fucking trying to do. Dude, I... Well, I guess what I'll have to do.
Do you think the game's just like glitching on you, maybe?
That's how I think. Maybe I have to just quit and come back. Gotta love it. Got to love it. That's unreal.
It was just glitching then, yeah. But only with that TV.
So there you guys have it. The solution was to the puzzle was to turn it off and turn it back on again. God, that's not my favorite. I think we've seen that already twice in this series with the fucking dial incident. The TV dial. He didn't fall that far, it doesn't seem like.
Whoa.
Ooh, I almost just jumped off the roof. I love the clothespins popping. I think that's such a funny... Well... That was pretty wild. Oops. Whatever cord that fucking thing's got on it, I need it. Yep, gotta love sounds like that, right? Oh yeah, I already see what's gotta happen here. Sorry, buddy. Well, you can bet I'm supposed to go in this fucking disgusting place. It's a loud ass freight elevator. There's six in there now? I see it. I can't tell if it's the eyeball. Oh, it's the eyeball. I thought maybe it was the hood. There's something up there. Maybe this is like the origin of the little mushroom gnome looking people. Oh, maybe I can't get in there. Oh, I understand. Oh, yes, I do. Oh, boy. Here we go. Oh, cool. Come here, Grammy. Oh no. Yeah. I wonder why these guys were crashing earlier. Some of them were like crashing their faces into the TV. So it's just like when they get so overwhelmed, they can't stand it. The cigarettes, the ashtray on the table. Oh, the cigarettes. This is going to be a running sequence. I can like almost guarantee you. Oh, maybe not. It's easier just to move if you grab it from the side. Oh. There's a key up in that fucking bear. That's the wrong combination of buttons there. Okay, I didn't think so, but said I'd check.
Are those scissors on the desk right next to you?
No, it's like a wind up for a toy. Okay, so here's the problem. I need the electricity on. Yeah, I can't move any of this shit. So, okay, then I take the grocery cart, which is easier to move from the side. Oh. Is it kind of automatically? Okay, yeah, that's where it's gonna sit.
So you just gotta drop it from the counter there.
Yeah. Trial run didn't go well. All right, fuck it, we'll make it happen live. Thanks, Rachel. You're the best. Oh, you fucking dweeb. Good thing, though, because I would have forgot to pull the switch anyways. I would have come back. I would have had to come back. The model of consistency. I hit the same goddamn spot 3 times right in a row. Come on. Good call, Rachel.
Well, the ghost cart's there.
No, I know. I know. I'm just looking at something else. Okay, I can't climb over that. I can't roll under it either. Practice run. Very important. That window on the rain sounds nice. Other way around. Rain on the window. You know what they say, execute or be executed.
Oh, I almost thought you were gonna make that.
Ew. This is gonna be a running scene. Oh shit. Oh, it's six. Count slightly red. Rachel, that looks very concerned. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit, he's coming. Oh, shit. Oh my fucking lord, dude. Thank you. That's six's shadow. Oh, what the fuck? Oh, I see. Okay. Which is my left hand on. I guess I'll just cut these. Inception City be quaking. This shit's really messing up the foundation. The hallway. Those warped cabinets. I'm very confused. Okay. Hold on, everyone. Again. Oh, I see. So you go to the one the music box is coming from. There we go. Jeez. Good thing I looked that up, or I'd be fucking struggling, I can't lie. No way, dude. Okay. I was like, where is that gonna put me back at? Okay. Evidently, that's not the answer. True, this is quite the puzzle. Is that six? Oh, it is. I'm pretty sure that's six, dude. This is gonna go over well. Oh man, I did not expect this game to end. I was being attacked by six. Oops, that's where I was supposed to go. Thank you. It was a drag to see what they did to my poor buddy. Oh, maybe I'm not supposed to hit his box again.
That's what I would have thought, too.
It seems like it.
I feel like I'm gonna destroy it, do you think?
Right after me. I get what I have to do now. The hand tech karate chop. Yeah. Okay. So I need to do this. Sorry, Six. Okay. She drops me so fast. Turn around with that hard haymaker right there. Okay. Hey! Let's see. Holy smokes, man. Ew. Ew, oh my god. This is disgusting. Oh my god, like this disgusting, like amorphous blob. Up, dude, get up! Don't drop me. Wow. getting older. By the Slender Man. Yep. So it was me going back in time to try and stop myself from saving Six. No shit.
That's why it was all the eyeballs. That's all you saw. It's very sad.
Yes, it is. Actually, I didn't think about that. Wow. As always, most games, I guess, if I get to the end credits, then I'm clapping for them. I don't play a lot of games to the end, then I'm like, ah, fuck this game. I hate this game. But that shit was pretty wild right there. Not the ending that I had anticipated. Because of the first one, I was like, oh yeah, we're gonna get out of this and have like a cool superpower. We fucking repelled that guy and we let Six, that little shit, should have known he was bad from the last game. Well, ambiguous, I guess. He's just doing what he's got to do to survive. But I'd like to read more about like the plot and Six's motivations and all that stuff. I don't know much about it. I tried purposely to avoid it, obviously.
Maybe Six knows that you were the Slender Man all along, and so he's trying to like end you early or something.
Yeah, but we worked together that whole time.
And holds him for a long time.
That's very interesting. Very shocked. You know, you guys saw it, but sorry, it's late. And after being scared, my yawns come out. All my body is returning back to stasis. I was shocked. I mean, I knew he was gonna drop me when he grabbed my hand. I was like, that fucker's gonna let me go for sure. I knew it. But look at, they have office dogs on here. That's so funny. On the credits. I knew he was gonna do it, but it takes a lot of balls for this studio to kill off your main character that you've played with and been invested in, or essentially make yourself the main character, your villain, which is pretty also ballsy, so kudos to them. Yeah, so that wraps Little Nightmares 2. I guess now in the following week, replacing this, like chronologically, we will now have two Undertales a week. Sorry, like I said, my brain is returning back to like resting mode, not like high survival setting. We'll go to Undertale twice a week. We'll get It Takes Two on Wednesdays, replacing Undertale. And then I'll probably wrap up God of War and Undertale right around the same time. Maybe.
What are you going to play next?
I haven't figured that out. Oh, I have Last of Us Part 2. And something else. I'm not sure yet. I haven't figured it out quite yet. But, yeah, as always, I mean, this game had more technical issues than the other one. Like puzzles not triggering, like when I was hitting the TV remote and it wasn't turning the TV off and shit. So like all in all, a little bit of a rougher experience, but still a fucking awesome game. I mean, for the couple headaches, have a guide ready. If you're playing it by yourself, have a guide ready. Unless you're just smarter than I am, which is very legitimately possible. Look at Rachel's got the yawnies now too. See? It's hard. You come down from a scary game. Your body's just like, that's it. There's something about it. Yawning and yawning. So Resident Evil will be the next scary game I play. And I have a feeling that it will really scare me. I mean, you heard Rachel. Like when I get scared, I go like,
whoa.
Ah. But Rachel was like, ah. So when we play when we play Resident Evil, I'm sure you'll hear a lot of Rachel. So yeah, I don't know how long these credits are gonna go on for. I like to let them roll because this these people worked hard on this game. It was a good game, so I'll let them roll while I yawn at you guys. And Rachel yawns.
Every time you yawn, I yawn.
We do a yawn trade. The yawn exchange. But, yeah, let's see real fast. Well, these credits roll if I can. See what 6 is about. Oh, lighter, she sneaked away. Blah, 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 blah. So is this Little Nightmares 2 prequel? It is a prequel, okay. Little Nightmares 2 ends right where Little Nightmares begins, essentially. Little Nightmares 2 ends where Little Nightmares begins. Okay, that kind of makes sense. Huh. It says, I'll read you the quick summary. Although Little Nightmares did a lot to expand the dark and twisted world 6 and Monolith in, as well as provide some context for the events of Little Nightmares, there's still a lot of questions that need answering. Both major characters have rather ambiguous endings, with Mono being stuck in a signal tower, the origins of which remain unknown, and 6's ultimate fate is subject to fan theories. Mono's true identity as the Thin Man reveals the characters are stuck in a time loop of some kind. Mono had to battle the Thin Man earlier in the game, but will he ever escape it? Does 6 really ever grow up to be a new lady, or is she the existing lady stuck in a time loop of her own? Her fate could be something else entirely, and the Little Nightmares community has no shortage of theories about what it could be. So no one knows, essentially. I'm glad I don't know either. Well, time is not linear. Mystery demons, there are a few concrete story. At this end of the second game, 6 shock fans by abandoning Mono, letting him fall to his dark fate as the signal towers. Thin Man, when they could have both escaped. Maybe 6 felt threatened by Mono's powers, or maybe she felt like he might be a liability. Huh. It seems like I missed one of the little shadow figures, but there's like a little secret Easter eggy ending if you collect all the shadow figures that are around, so...
Was it maybe because you had to restart that one and you didn't go back and do it again?
No, there's like little like glyphs around. I found 5 out of them. I missed one somewhere. Just that, like I said, those little black shadow glitches.
Oh.
No, not the dolls. That was the last game. But yeah, so you'll have to go check out the alternative ending scene on your own. Oh, also that article I just read you with all the hypotheses about Little Nightmares 2 is an article from Game Rant written by Megan Elizabeth Gingrich? How would you say that name?
Maybe Gingrich. Gingrich?
Gingrich. That's what we're going to go with. So thank you for that information, Megan. Constanze? I think that's Constance. That's from Good Mythical Morning. They Link reads Constance off of a page as Constanze. And the other day I did the same thing, like a fucking idiot. I was like, Constanze? What kind of name is that? And then Rachel was like, I think that's Constance. I was like, oh, I am dumb. Jeez, these credits are long. It's like, I want to give these people credit for the game they made, but also it's like, guys, who do you think you are leaving these credits so long? Rachel's face.
I was going to say the same thing, but I thought it would be too, like, douchey.
No. I mean, maybe I'll just roll through them at double the speed. I'll just...
Lots of people worked on it.
Yeah, these are... We're into the accountants and the revenue people. Which, like I said... I get it, guys. It's just like watching a movie, right? Credits aren't fun, but... So, these are all the people... I mean, there's a lot of work that goes into making these motherfuckers come together.
Bug translator.
Yeah, it sounds like they have, like, a collection of different... like, we got worms, we got roaches, we got beetles. And we gotta make sure they can all work together. So, we have a bug translator. And there were flies buzzing around and all kinds of shit. Man, imagine like, well, I guess we saw it. Remember the credits for Death Stranding?
I don't.
They were like, on the beach, they were, took like a long time. Oh, it was like telling story and showing you the credits at the same time.
I can't stop yawning. That was like the 7th time I've yawned in the past 10 minutes.
Holy smokes. So, all right, well, these are probably going to get sped up because it's taking a long time. So I'll just start my sign off now. Thank you for joining us for this series, Little Nightmares 2. That's Little Nightmares 1 and 2, both in the bag now. So if you want to check out the old series, which this is technically a prequel, so if you want to watch them in order, I guess you can basically just watch them from like this, boom, boom, watch the second one too. different page all set up for Little Nightmares 1. But it will continue to put the light on different series and roll out different different programming for y'all. Y'all can see a couple different games a week, and it was fun to play this one while it was around. So, as always, you got, you know, life is a eternal and constant struggle. Although, you know, it's great and everything, don't get me wrong. It's not like I hate it, but it's also extremely difficult. And if you find that you're having a difficult time, reach out to somebody. There's the hotlines, you know, there's people you can call, there's online counselors, there's all that stuff, family, friends, you know, your friends especially, you know, would do anything probably to make sure that you're all right, ultimately. So, you know, reach out, let somebody know you're not feeling that well, you know, and I know also not everybody can be helpful in that situation, but I said people around you, people that love you, care about you, they genuinely care about your well-being. So hopefully you guys are taking steps to get things right with your mental health, and you know, do little things daily, do things you love, things that bring you peace and happiness through your days. Little baby steps. It doesn't all come at once, but you know, like I said, take those baby steps, take care of yourselves, and we'll catch y'all on the next series. So thanks for joining us, and we'll catch you next time. Bye.
Bye.